What can you tell me about the Banuk?
The Banuk women. Snow witches all. Cold eyes, cold... They choose to live up there in Ban-Ur, in the ice. Trying to have a conversation, it's like chipping them out of the stuff. They prefer machines for company. That's why I'm putting my shards on this rumor.
Then they might not want outsiders to know about this place.
Their mystic act. No care for possessions, for luxuries. Pile of slag. Those people bargain harder than the winter frost.
What can you tell me about the Banuk?
The Banuk women. Snow witches all. Cold eyes, cold... They choose to live up there in Ban-Ur, in the ice. Trying to have a conversation, it's like chipping them out of the stuff. They prefer machines for company. That's why I'm putting my shards on this rumor.
Then they might not want outsiders to know about this place.
Their mystic act. No care for possessions, for luxuries. Pile of slag. Those people bargain harder than the winter frost.
So is there any more to the rumor about this camp?
The last bunch just wanted to know about the reward. Hey, you're a smart one. This camp isn't even big enough for a name up where the snow won't thaw. They say the Banuk there live alongside machines. Peaceful as you like. Keep them, use them, sing to them. If it's true, if we learn how they do it, think how valuable that would be to all the tribes.
When you say valuable, you mean they'd pay you for it.
Girl, I'm not made of straw.
Are you some kind of merchant? You don't seem to have any wares.
More of an explorer.
But you send other people to do your exploring.
All right, more of an opportunist. Girl. Nora, girl. Huntress. We live in a world of opportunities. Risky opportunities. But why should risk stand in the way of a lucrative prospect for the likes of me? All right. I'm more of a gambler.
If I did look into your rumor...
You won't need to climb up the shoulders of the world for it. It's on the edge of Banuk land, beneath the anvil of the moon. And you look like you know your way around the savage east. The east. If it's true they walk among machines without fear in this camp, well, you can't miss that, can you? Payment on return.
Nice to see outlanders dressed in good Karja gear.
Can I interest you in a reasonable share of a lucrative opportunity? You'll sell me their services. No questions asked on my part. Able-bodied adventurers, preferably with no friends or family, but I'm not choosy. Can I interest you in a reasonable share of a lucrative opportunity?
Daybreak. Yesterday's gone.
You'll sell me their services. No questions asked on my part. Able-bodied adventurers, Preferably with no friends or family, but I'm not choosy.
You need to win 3 half-suns at our hunting grounds to gain admittance to the lodge.
You mean these?
Very well, then. Congratulations, and welcome. Our members reap rewards and adventure and live on in legend.
Am I a member now?
No, you're only a fledgling. Junior members are called thrushes. To join and become a thrush, you need a senior member called a hawk to sponsor you.
So I need to find a hawk?
Yes, but a hawk can only sponsor one hunter at a time, and I'm afraid most of them already have one.
I've overcome worse odds. Where do I start?
Upstairs. Present yourself to the Sun Hawk Assis, our leader, who should introduce you to a hawk. I hope it's worth it.
What do you mean?
You'll see.
By the sun! King Avad's edict really is taking effect. Never thought I'd see a Nora here and a woman at that. So, you have marks for me?
What do you mean?
From the hunting grounds. Oh, right. You're new here.
What edict?
King Avad insisted that the Hunter's Lodge had to welcome everyone. Man, woman, outlander, regardless of tribe. Ursa, captain of the Vanguard, came in and delivered that news personally. You should have been there. It was glorious. But I figured they would sweep it under the rug and say no woman or outlander qualified. Yet here you are.
Are you a member?
Me? No. Karja don't exactly encourage their daughters to run around hunting machines. But all the changes in Meridian have been good to me. I don't think the Oseram know how to sell to us Karja. The trader I worked for last couldn't sell flowers to a bee. He was too plain hammered, as they like to say. This is a much better job. I figure I'll be able to open my own shop soon enough.
What do you want with my marks?
You hunters and your badges. I'm not gonna take them. I'm going to give you a weapon that sets you apart. Yeah, I thought that'd get your attention. If you earn marks in all 3 trials at each of the 5 hunting grounds, come to me. I can give you up to 3 weapons, one for 15 half-suns, one for 15 full-suns, and one you'll love for all blazing suns.
What do I do with these marks?
If you get the same mark from all the hunting ground trials, I can give you a Hunter's Lodge weapon. Show me what marks you've earned, and we'll see if you qualify for one of these special weapons I have for you.
I'm a little short on marks.
No problem. Once you have marks from all 15 trials, you'll be able to get the next Hunter's Lodge weapon for me.
Thank you. So loud, I'm still deaf in one ear.
How's that wrestling on the rules? Here's what I don't get about the Sundom. All these fancy decorations everywhere, it's downright embarrassing.
You're Nora. I'm the mournful Naman. My apologies that we meet like this.
Like this?
In grief. You hold yours close, like a talisman. Wait, forgive me. You didn't come for reparations? Someone you lost to the Sunring?
No. I know about the Red Raids, but the Karja owe me nothing.
I see. Well, I could use the help of a strong-willed outlander. Then I would owe you very much indeed. These people seek to honor their loved, their lost, with their own voices, not mouthing Karja rituals to Karja stone. But there are obstacles. While Meridian holds its breath for any disturbance, these robes only tie my hands.
What kind of obstacles?
The first pilgrim is an Asaram who seeks to visit the Shrine of Kings on the road to the city. He waits there now, forbidden to enter by an old sun priest who suffer no heathen. This Utaru lost her companion on the edge of the jewel, at a pool where snap moths gather. The shrine was built there to ward off the machines, and its effectiveness leaves much to be desired. And the Manuk would paint a mark on the sun's climb. Call to the machine spirits, I understand. They need no beckoning. Glinthawks perch there, drawn to the spire's shining.
So clear the machines out of two shrines and move a priest out of the other.
All I can ask for is your charity and that their stories are heard.
Naman, rituals and prayers can't bring back those who are lost.
No, but it can help those who grieve to find themselves. It can lend them strength and hope, like a new sunrise.
I didn't think your priesthood would ask outsiders for help.
If only the sun would set on our pride. Until this is done, I am no sun priest. To wear a red robe was an aspiration. I aspired. Now our hoods make us blind. We whisper reconciliation, but forget how the old king's priests sang the words and blessed the killing.
The killing? You mean the Red Raids?
Yes. And the sacrifices that came after.
Why did the priests go along with all that bloodshed?
Sometimes we Karja are more concerned with what is tradition than what is right.
Huh. Maybe the Karja and Nora aren't so different. You're disappointed with the Sun Priests, but you still wanted to be one?
I spent my whole life looking up to the temple. My brother's voice echoing in his arches turned me away, and how he tried. In the end, he said, when we were loved, our robes were dyed in cinnabar. Now they are stained in blood.
How so?
Our robes are handed down to us. Most of the old priests fled rather than be seen in the glare of a new sun. And so we are left to wear their sins. For me, at least, they hang heavy.
Where is your brother now?
He waits for me on the trail of the sun, I hope. He spoke out against the sacrifices. For a priest to question the Sun King's will, his punishment was worst of all.
You lost someone you loved, too. I'm sorry.
No, not lost. When I took on these robes, I found his memory.
I'll do what I can to help those in mourning.
To honor their memories is to honor us all.
Ursa goes out there with her best.
A long day today.
Kids are always running around playing by the noble market.
These aren't goods, they're necessities.
Soldiers
would you like to buy something?
Just inside the main gate. And
don't forget to stock up before you're on the road. Come take a look. I'll give you a good price. Sorry about not stopping when you're in the thick of it.
Everyone needs a splash of color in their lives. Come, let's talk it over.
You have no need to loiter around here.
The sun shines on those who mind their own, so they say.
Stocking up?
You're in for a treat. It's quite a show.
Don't bother me, Outlander. I don't need a mercenary. I need a miracle. Someone who can tell me who slaughtered my men.
I'm a good tracker. Maybe I can help. What happened?
Mass murder. That's what. 5 night guards shredded like cabbage out there in the quarry.
5 men murdered? How?
Don't know. One was a buddy from before the liberation. We worked this quarry together as slaves for the Mad King. My friend, may he walk forever in the light, knew how to fight. Fiends who did this must have had stealth or numbers.
Could machines have killed them?
Don't see how. The quarry is fenced and gated, and I've never seen a Glinthawk do anything like this.
Anything strike you as strange or out of the ordinary?
Well, let's see. Oh, yeah. Chunks of corpses, gushing blood. Sorry. Pressure's getting to me. Not used to murder. Nah, nothing unusual. Well, except we've been doing a little blasting lately, and Saravad said... No, that's just stupid.
You've been using explosives?
Sure. To clear away bedrock and get to the good stuff, we do it for a week or so every year. But that's got nothing to do with the dead. They were torn apart, not blown up.
What exactly did Saravad say?
Ah, nothing. Kept babbling about a pile of rocks out there. Said he didn't remember it from yesterday. I told him that this here is a quarry where we move rocks all day. So rocks getting moved ain't so surprising, lunkhead.
I'll have a look around the quarry.
If you think it'll help.
I've seen this 4 times already.
I love this bit. Oh, you're in for a treat. It's quite a show.
Sun.
The sun never fails.
feels like it's under my skin.
Yeah.
isn't in me. Can't carry more. Brew that up later. Good hit. This'll do. think I'm in the clear. For later. My turn. Got too much already.
This is what you intend. To bring these ancient things back to life.
Their power serves us.
Machine demons from beneath the ground. It's a nightmare.
Nightmares, yes. The worst dreams of our enemies come true. Yes, rise.
Will destroy us all.
They will only destroy our enemies and bring us back the lands that were.
Stop working.
Search the area. We may have intruders.
Forgive this intrusion, Aloy. You left me no choice.
Who is this?
An interested party. Now, the focuses are disabled, but I don't know for how long. The rest is up to you.
Who is this?
The Nora girl lives?
Kill her!
No, you had your chance.
Let's go.
spoil your fun.
Hear me out!
You came for me. I'm ready.
Hear me out! I promise. I'll tell you everything.
I know you will. The killers who came for me at the Proving, who are they?
The Eclipse. Some kind of holy warriors. A cult of the Shadow Carja.
Shadow Carja?
Except they're not like any Carja I've known. They don't pray to the sun. They worship some kind of devil.
I'm not interested in their superstitions.
Oh, it's not a superstition. Their devil is real. It has a name, a voice. The most terrible voice. And they do its bidding.
The Eclipse were sent to kill me because I look like another woman. Older, maybe twice my age, short hair. Who is she?
I don't know. My focus found her image once, in the ruins at Maker's End. Maybe you can find her there.
You found her image in the ruins? How?
There was a door beside it, a kind of ancient device that contained the woman's image. My focus recorded the location. You do look like her. Is she your mother?
I'm the one asking questions. You say this devil, the Eclipse worship, has a name?
Hades. That's what they call it.
Hades. And you've heard it speak?
Steel to my soul. I heard. Just once, when it saw you. Such a voice. A cold, awful jangle. It scrapes your bones. It hollows your guts. A metal sound, but like nothing dug from the earth or smelted in a forge.
And what did it say?
System threat detected. Just three words. But in the voice of a devil.
Why are the Eclipse digging up ancient machines? And how do they get them to work?
I thought they wanted them for scrap, but they brought them back to life. Plugged some kind of device into the corpses so that Hades could whisper to them and call them from their grave.
I've fought that kind of machine before. Are there others?
Yes. The ones you fought today, they call corruptors. But there are others. Much bigger. Bristling with ancient weapons. Those they call Deathbringers. I've only seen them buried in the ground. But after today, anything is possible.
Sounds to me like they're raising an army.
If so, the world will fall. And I helped dig the pit.
What are these Eclipse cultists after, besides me?
They never said. But given the Carja civil war, they must want to overthrow Sun King of Ard and take Meridian back.
What do I have to do with that?
I don't know.
When they attacked the Proving, a man came for me. Tall, strong, dead eyes.
Helis.
And who is he?
The Terror of the Sun. Stacker of Corpses, we Osirom called him when he was the Mad Sun King's champion. If only he'd died with his king. But now he leads the Eclipse. I tell you, he's the most dangerous man alive.
How did the Eclipse recruit you? I know they took your family hostage, but why you?
I was a scrounger, a rummager in dark places, good at what I do. I suppose they knew I would serve them well as a scout. I had taken a delve near Maker's End. When I surfaced, they were waiting. I laughed when I saw the priest. But then he showed me Helis's encouragement. I didn't laugh after that. They gave me a focus to watch my every move. I followed orders.
You had access to Meridian. Why didn't they get to Avad through you?
Too much dirt under my nails for an audience with the one true Sun King. But whatever Ursa or Eren told me, the Eclipse heard every word through my focus. That's why I couldn't warn you. If I'd tried, they would have killed my family.
I've heard enough. It's time to finish this.
I won't beg for my life. But if there's any mercy in you, free my family. Please.
Where would I find them?
My focus recorded the location. There are always guards there. You look like you can handle yourself.
It will take many good deeds to make up for the crimes you've committed.
You're sparing me? After all I've done?
Yes. Forge a new life, Olin. One of better make.
Then the rest of my life will be lived in your debt.
Go to the place where your family is being held and wait for me. We'll make their lives the first ones you save.
I didn't earn this mercy, but I will die to make myself worthy of it. I will be waiting for you.
Might need that. For the trail. To override them, but where would I find it? can't scare them off. Need ammo.
That's over with. Thanks for the help. Come on over here and have a word. Come on, what are you waiting for?
What are you doing out here all alone? Where are your men?
I'm not gonna risk their lives. I don't mind putting my worthless ass on the line, but not theirs. Sorry I had to drag you into it.
Don't worry. This is just an average day for me. You know, take down some machines, track some killers.
Right. I'd hate to see a busy morning for you. Ready to get started?
Tell me exactly what happened to Ursa. Start from the beginning.
No one knows for sure. She left in the middle of the night with a few of her best men.
Her best men? But she didn't bring you?
No. I'd been drinking a lot. Or maybe she thought... damn, I don't know. I couldn't hack it. Search parties found their bodies the next day and the corpses of some Shadow Karja cowards. It was an ambush. The Shadow Karja are animals. They beat her so bad we can't even show her face before burial.
I'm so sorry, Eric.
Yeah, well, when I find the soldiers who did this, they'll be sorry too.
You don't have any idea why she left in the middle of the night?
No. But it must have been urgent. A message, a report of some new Shadow Karja threat, I don't know.
Why would the Shadow Karja do this?
Because they hate us. And Ursa most of all. She teamed up with Avad to kick their asses out of Meridian. They've been licking their wounds for 2 years, but... they finally found a way to get back at her.
All right. Show me where Ursa fell, and I'll do what I can to help.
Come on, follow me.
Why would Ursa come all the way out here?
I don't know. It doesn't make sense.
Is this Shadow Karja territory?
No. They broke the ceasefire as soon as they set foot in the cleft.
Thank you.
almost there.
Hey, this is it. Where the ambush happened. Our soldiers have been over it, but maybe that fancy artifact of yours can find a clue or something. Please. I need to find the bastards that did this.
These look like drag marks. A shadow car just here. Must be Shadow Karja armor. Those bloodstains, not the kind that would pull arrows scattered there. They look like smears. Someone move a body through here.
What do you see there?
This stain forms a line, as if blood dripped off the edge of something, like a cart. See? Cart tracks. I think someone moved the bodies here, then scattered them across the field.
Wait. Are you saying the dead found here were killed somewhere else? But why would the Shadow Karja do that?
At this point, I'm not taking it for granted that the Shadow Karja are responsible.
Of course they were.
Well, let's follow these tracks and find out. I'll find a use for you.
I get why they wanted Ersa dead. Why fake an ambush?
There's more to this. And we're gonna figure it out.
These guys aren't Shadow Carja. They're from my tribe, the Oseram.
Is this how your people usually greet each other?
On me!
Let's see how they like this!
I think it's calling in machines. Get ready.
Thank you.
you.
Asaram, not Shadow Carja. Looks like I was wrong about everything, as usual. Please, use that second sight of yours. I have to know what really happened.
I'm on it. So much blood. Those rocks, they're shattered. Looks like you could mount some equipment on that thing. Something hit these stones. Something I've never seen before. These look like Vanguard. There's no blood on them. Ursa's men didn't fight back. Those leather straps. Armor straps. Cut with a knife. And a rock with blood on it. A lot of people died here. A massacre. There, by the tripod. A used power cell.
This is Ursa's helmet. I thought she died in the field below, but must have been here. All this trickery. For what? Feels like it's just torturing me.
I have a theory. But it takes a little imagination.
So far, your theories are better than other people's facts.
All right. I think the Oseram ambushed Ursa and her men with a new weapon. They mounted it on that tripod up there. It fires waves of force, maybe sound. Looks like it cracked the stone there. I think it paralyzes people instead of killing them. It dropped the vanguard right there. No blood on their weapons. No fight.
But why paralyze them if you're only gonna move them and gut them?
They were trying to hide something. Look here, a bloody rock.
That they used to smash Ursa's face in.
Or someone else's. These leather straps have been cut, as if they took the armor off someone.
That can't be. Her body is lying in state in Meridian. I saw it.
You said she was unrecognizable. Maybe they switched another body into her armor, someone around the same size, and mutilated it enough so it could have been anyone. Even Ursa. Go back to Meridian. Take another look at that body. If it's really Ursa, of course I'm wrong. But if I'm right...
Then my sister could be alive. I'm going. Meet me back there when you can.
Move along. You have no need to loiter around here.
Always stay bright. Always stay alert. That's what I say.
We are paying for Sun King Duran's sins. You mark my words.
I need a moment. My duties today are endless.
Who runs this place?
Captain Balan. In the parapet by the market building.
Any word about our missing men?
I'm still working on it. So the Karja are allied with the Oseram?
Hard to believe, but it's true. Mad Sun King Duran raided the Oseram for years. Avad managed to get them on his side. He had help, of course. Urser and Eren played a part. Oseram siblings, bigger than life. They gathered an army to free Meridian. I marched with them, scaled the North Cliff with my men, and secured the Temple of the Sun. Sent Duran's kestrels and priests packing. Now Oseram are a common sight in the city. And a common sound, too. They sure bicker a lot.
Did an Oseram named Olin come through here?
Twice. He was part of the royal delegation to the Nora. When they passed through on the way, then back. They brought back stories of a vicious attack on your people. My condolences, of course.
Do you know where Olin is now?
Not exactly. But he was on his way to Meridian, I'm certain of that. Everyone goes to Meridian.
You said something happened with Nakoa.
The Nora girl? Yes, something happened. Attempted murder. Prefect Zaid can tell you more about it. You can find him near the main tower, up the steps.
Wait. Zaid is here?
He is. Look, I've heard what your people say about him, but he swears it's a case of mistaken identity. If there's a shadow to him, I've never been able to prove it, and the forbearance he showed towards this Nakoa woman was impressive. Oh, speak to him. Maybe he knows where she went. And try not to assault him, please.
What do you need, Captain?
I sent several patrols east when we got word of corrupted machines there. I'll let them confirm my fears, so I sealed the gates. But it looks like we left some men behind when they were closed. Walid, tell them what happened.
Machines attacked us near an abandoned Nora village, sir. Lakir told us to pull back. Then I lost sight of the others.
Never seen a Nora woman before, soldier? Have some respect. Report to her, not to me.
Lakir always stresses reporting back, so that's what I did. I felt terrible about leaving them behind.
Now that the gates are open again, I can send someone after them.
I need to go.
Let me know if there's any news about those missing men.
I can tell from your tone you've heard of me. Let me ease your mind. There seem to be wild stories about me among your tribe. But the Nora have me mistaken for someone else. I'm not sure where the fault lies, but the fog of war often breeds confusion. Unfortunately, some refuse to acknowledge the error. So it was with the last Nora who came through here.
The last Nora who came through here. You mean Nakoa?
Is that her name? Oh, well. It was a very unfortunate situation. She attacked me in broad daylight. If one of my men hadn't spotted her, I might well have been injured. But we were able to subdue her without harm.
What did you do with her?
I let her go, of course. It was clear she thought I was responsible for unspeakable things. So, in a sense, her actions were justifiable. I explained that she was wrong, then sent her on her way. Sadly, I don't think she believed me.
Where is Nakoa now?
I don't know exactly. She left raving that she would find a way to bring me down. But I did hear a report from the garrison at Lonesome Rock that a young woman had been abducted by bandits. Might have been her.
So you deny participating in the Red Raids?
No, I didn't say that. I did have a role in those operations, albeit a very limited one. But all this nonsense about torture and murder, that wasn't me. They have me confused with some other commander. I don't doubt some of my comrades did bad things, but Sun King of Odd has worked hard to eliminate such brutality.
You've really gone out of your way to help, Prefect Said.
It's no trouble. The Sun King wishes to make amends with your people, and I am his humble servant.
I'll go to Lonesome Rock and get to the bottom of this. I promise you that.
You do that. And if our men are anything less than helpful, please let me know.
I had to take over my brother's ship today. There's a sun's rise and he's off courting that noble girl.
here and do
can't trust him. Not after what Yon told me.
Sun King of
Vod. The garrison is my only lead.
Why does King Avad protect the people of Sunfall?
Snow haze. White as bone. That thought got dark. Sun's making a show of it. flatten whatever stands in its way. Things drawing back. Just stay out of their way for now. Fascinating, if they weren't looking for me. this a little easier. Tuck that away. That's a machine I can't override. Not until I've learned more.
Thank you.
go again. This machine yet. I need to find a way to learn.